that saved a wretch.
For the promise he would inherit the world did not come to Abraham or his descendants through the law, but through the righteousness of faith. For this reason, the promise depends on faith, in order that it may rest on grace, so that it may be guaranteed to all his descendants, not only to the adherents of the law, but also to those who share the faith of Abraham, who is the father of us all, as it is written, I have made you the father of many nations. In the presence of God in whom he believed, who gives life to the dead and calls into existence the things that do not exist, hoping against hope, he believed that he would become the father of many nations, according to what was said, so shall your descendants be. Therefore, it was reckoned to him as righteousness.
There are so many huge concepts tucked into today's verses, including faith, grace, sharing, the presence of God, life, existence, law, and righteousness. It's good to grow in our understanding of these things, but it's even more important to remember that Scripture is far more than a collection of theological concepts or rules to follow. It's first and foremost the story of God. Through God's gift of His written word, which we call the Bible, we are invited to discover who God is, the Trinity, an exploding community of love. We are invited to discover who we are and to find our place in God's story, the most wonderful story of all. We are invited to discover that together we are invited into abundant life and love with God today and forever. This is why Christ Jesus came, fully God, fully human, God with us. Jesus, because of his love for us, made a way for us to be made righteous, right with God, welcoming us into the exploding community of love for which we were created, by taking upon himself the consequences for every poor, bad, or downright evil choice made by every single person who has ever lived, past, present, and future, and initiated the undoing of all of those consequences, along with the restoration of all things. God can do anything. He gives life to the dead and calls into existence things that do not exist. No matter where you're at today, no matter who you are or what you've done, God is calling you into abundant life and love by calling you to surrender all that you are to Christ Jesus. Will you join me in saying yes to God with everything you've got, all of your passion and prayer and intelligence and energy?
Father and brightness of his glory, whom angels desire to behold. Teach me to do your will, that guided by your Spirit, I may come to that blessed city of everlasting day, where all are one in heart and mind, where there is safety and eternal peace, happiness, and delight, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be forever. Amen.